His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa ratified and issued Law No. 8 for this year on amending Article 9 of Law 11 of 1975 with respect to passports. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa received today at Glabia Palace the General Secretariat of the General Federation of the Bahrain Trade Unions, headed by its Secretary General Hassan Al Halwachi. His Royal Highness affirmed the government's keenness to support the Federation and to facilitate its work on all levels. The Federation's Secretary General hailed His Royal Highness's numerous efforts, which boosted the Kingdom's status on the international level. His Royal Highness stressed the importance of supporting the government's efforts and initiatives that aim to provide a suitable working environment for the citizens in the public and private sectors. He expressed the government's keenness to adopt initiatives that aim to provide better job opportunities to the citizens and wished the Federation every success. Mr. Al-Halwachi conveyed the greetings of the Federation's affiliates to the Prime Minister for his keenness to train and develop the national labor and affirmed the Federation's keenness to deliver a bright image of the labor sector on all levels. President of the Supreme Council of Islamic Affairs, Sheikh Abdullah bin Khalid Al Khalifa, chaired the regular meeting today. The council condemned the terrorist acts in Tunisia, Turkey, Egypt, Belgium, and Pakistan, calling for world cooperation to combat terrorism. The council also condemned Israel's confiscation of Palestinian territories in the West Bank. The council then congratulated His Royal Highness the Prime Minister on being honored with the Leader Award 2016 by the International Federation of Training and Development Organizations. The meeting then discussed a number of scheduled topics. PDF Commander-in-Chief Field Marshal Sheikh Khalifa bin Ahmed Al Khalifa received advisor to the Jordanian monarch for military affairs and chairman of the Joint Chief of Staff, Lieutenant General Mishal Mohammed Al Zabin, and his accompanying delegation to attend the 13th meeting of the Bahraini-Jordanian Joint Committee. The PDF Commander-in-Chief hailed the bilateral relations and keenness of both countries to strengthen the brotherly relations. The meeting involved discussions about bilateral cooperation and joint military coordination in order to further enhance their relations. In its meeting today, under the chairmanship of the Speaker Ahmed bin Ibrahim al-Mulla, the Representatives' Council approved Decree No. 70 for the year 2014, amending some provisions of Decree Law No. 5 of 2002 to approve the accession to the Convention of the Elimination of All Forms of Discrimination Against Women. The Minister of Justice, Islamic Affairs and Awqaf, Sheikh Khalid bin Ali al-Khalifa, the Minister of Shura and Representatives' Affairs, Ghanim al-Bu'aynain, representatives of the Foreign Ministry and other concerned authorities stressed that the decree is not conflicting with the provisions of the Islamic Sharia. After detailed discussion, the Council decided to refer the decree to the Shura Council for opinion. Bahrain joined the Convention on the Elimination of All Forms of Discrimination Against Women, CEDAW, in 2002, but submitted several reservations due to conflict with Islamic Sharia law, traditions, and principles. The Minister of Representatives and Shura Council's Affairs, Ghanim al-Bu'aynain, told the Bahrain News Agency that the vote on the redrafting of the reservations of Bahrain to the Convention does not mean that Bahrain withdrew its reservations on certain provisions of the Convention on the CEDAW relating to the Islamic law. He stressed that the Kingdom of Bahrain is committed to the implementation of this agreement with no commitment to substances which affect the sovereignty of the state and those violating Islamic law. The Minister said that the redrafting of the Kingdom's reservations on certain articles of the Convention take into account the inviolability of national sovereignty and the provisions of Islamic Sharia, and that the Kingdom of Bahrain still has reservations on some of the terms of the convention related to Islamic Sharia.